Previously on Agora Core.
I am the Leech Haeus. There is a library in Arn. I want the great books. All the great mages of the time of chaos and the time of heroes.
Yes, sir.
You believe Arn might be the ancient name for Ardlatla?
Okay, and that's up in the top left-hand corner of the map.
It is.
Cool.
I am Dara Frey. I saw dead bodies, and there's some sort of hideous form. A many-mouthed creature.
We are going that way, and we are hardened warriors. Some of us are. We could protect you and grant you passage to where you need to get to.
I have a contact or so who knows one or two things, huh? Maybe we help each other out.
Really good, lead on.
I have a lizard man friend called Grinx, and he may be able to get you inside. I can help you, but I will keep hold of your Errol Flynn armor until you provide me my chemical binding book. I can get you into Red Tor. It'll have to be now.
Agora Core Podcast. An original roleplay using Dungeons & Dragons 5th Edition. Player characters and Dungeon Master interact online using Roll20 and Skype. Dungeon Master and Podcast Editor John Paget. Player characters played by Dan, Ben, Finn, Terry, Ralph, and Rob.
Once inside, it's up to you. He presents some robes to you, some hooded robes. It says this will give you some basic disguise in case you do run into anyone whilst you are inside the Red Hall. Again, I have not been inside the Red Hall. The lizards who are inside are privileged. They must stay inside the Red Hall. But my contacts have given me this map, and I've brought you a script which may help you in your quest. And please do not forget that I will, if you provide me with Alpho's Book of Chemical Binding, you can have back your precious armor.
Are these cloaks magical hiding cloaks or just cloaks that will let us blend in?
They're black hooded cloaks. Nothing more.
So that's just what people wear there.
Regular old cloaks.
Okay.
If someone just looks at you for a second, they won't realize that you're not a lizard. He says, yes, I wasn't sure if you had any draconic language skills.
No.
No.
I have a comprehend language spell.
Ah, maybe that is useful then. In case it does not work, then I will give you the text. Draconic for library, which I am drawing now. Can you see it?
Yes.
If you would like to write it down, he's written it in the air. It'll disappear in a moment, so if you write it down.
Fine, we copy it down.
I hope you do, because you will need it.
Okay, let's write this down.
It's envelope H bag.
I believe that's Pisces.
And what is the script for?
Library.
It spells library.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
So are the first and last symbols supposed to be the same?
Yes.
Oh.
Okay, cool. Okay. So it's envelope, Pisces envelope. I don't know.
It's rounder than an envelope.
Gumball machine.
It's rounder than an envelope. The top is round.
More like Kenny from South Park.
Doing the Egyptian.
That's right. Egyptian, yeah.
Okay, you got it?
I think so.
Okay, and sure. It slowly disappears from the air. The other thing I provide, we have given you a map outline, which should aid you.
I saw that. Sacred entrance to Mount Simriana.
So what do these configuration, contentment, and congress mean?
This is how it is run in the Red Hall for our society. Configuration is where the bureaucracy goes on. Predominantly, this is the grey lizards. Contentment is where the people who control the lizard population, where they relax, and the Congress is where they do their decision-making. And then you have the sacred Semoana Mountain, which I would not expect you to go there. It is sacred ground, so be warned.
Do you have any idea in which area the library is likely to be?
I do not. This is as much as I know. There is talk of a library of ancient knowledge, but as I say, those who are without, and those who are in, remain in. I am not so privileged. The plan to get you in is simple. There is a loose part of the pipe here, which we can open. We will let you in. Quite a ways in, there is a yellow marker. At that point, there's another loose piece of pipe you can open and get into the Red Hall from there. And within a time frame, you can get back that way as well. You have 7 hours to get what you need, after which time the pipe will be sealed.
How long would it take for us to cross the map from one side to another by foot?
To cross by foot would take roughly an hour.
It's not a huge area to search, but...
No, just be careful. It is midnight now, and so although this is as quiet as it will get, it doesn't mean that this inner city is deserted. There will still be those active, still running errands, decisions. You must still be careful, but this is your best chance. If you do not get out by the time limit, then you will have to find another way out. It is not impossible, but it is much more difficult.
So, and do we get out the same way we
did?
If you can come back to us in 7 hours, then my two lizards, they are to remain here and will let you out. After 7 hours, they cannot do that anymore. There may be ways through the sewers. There may be other ways for you to get out, but you'll have to do the best you can.
Why can they not let us out after 8 hours?
Because it would be too suspicious. We cannot leave this way open. There are pests out there, and lizard folk. They must get back to their own duties.
I believe our lives are more important than their duties. You don't even tell us exactly where this library is. I'm not sure you're holding up your end of the bargain very well at all.
I wish you do well. I have investment in your success.
Not well enough to keep them there for an extra hour, or two, or three. You disgust me. I shake my head.
Do what you can, Dark One.
7 hours should be more than enough.
We still don't know where the library is, right?
Nope.
All right.
The yellow marked area of the pipe should lead you out among the area of contentment.
Would a locate object help us find the library? Because I could be...
I do not know your spell ways. And out of character. I'm not sure, because you're not even sure if it exists. You're just going by word of mouth.
In the old rules, at least, you had to have seen the objects.
Yeah, and I would think something
applies. I think it's normally, it's an object you're familiar with.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you're going by myth at the moment. It's like saying, find Robin Hood.
Well, all you've got to think of is like a room full of books, and then there you got it.
I like the books have to be familiar to you.
Room for the books. That's for at least us, wouldn't it? Yeah.
One last thing.
There's a slow pan and focuses on you.
Do you know what the library looks like?
He hesitates and says, ancient scrolls, I imagine. Whatever elvens like to do. It was created, if it's real, before lizard men came here.
Ooh.
So it would be further underground, I would think.
Further underground than the hall.
I suppose. Unless it is in the Mount Simuana, but I am speculating.
We're going to have to go to Mount Simuana, aren't we?
Right, shall we, then?
Okay, so they open up a section of the pipe. You can crawl in. And it's big enough for a human to crawl down.
We crawl down.
Okay. He says, one more thing I should make you aware of. The grey lizards may look fragile, and indeed they are, but they are very perceptive. Good luck. And they close it behind you. Okay, you crawl down?
Yeah.
for a time it's a little wet. You can feel a light breeze from behind you, just brushes against you as you crawl along. Who's in front?
Not me.
I can go in front.
Yeah, I'll go right behind him.
Okay.
As long as it's someone with good night vision.
In which case, I probably shouldn't go at the front because I don't have amazing night vision.
Cool.
Okay.
It's Nomo then?
Yeah, I've got night vision.
So. Okay. Nomo, you do see a yellow marker ahead of you.
I'll whisper to Icky, what were we supposed to do with the yellow marker?
Isn't that where we were meant to get out of the pipe?
Yes, I think so. I think that there should be some sort of exit.
Okay. I'll look for an exit.
All right, give me a perception check. You can hear nothing untoward. In fact, it seems very quiet. There's a little bit of a breeze going on. Nomo, you do see that beneath you there's a part of the pipe which you think would undo if you just gave it a bit of a push. Put some force on it.
Okay. I'll see if I can gently push and maybe if there's anywhere I can get a grip on it to keep it from just falling out.
All right. Investigation check. Okay. You give it a prod and it just goes thwap and hits part of the pipe behind it. It opens up. You can get out.
Yeah. I'll jump out in ready martial arts form.
Okay, nice.
Without the scream.
Yep, so you get out. There appears to be some sort of marble background. Imagine marble and meringue mixed together. But because it's dark, all the natural light's gone, so it just leaves this reddish glow. And the surface is very pot. There are lots of large hobbit-like bubbles that are outside of it, almost like pods. And these are dotted around this area. With your natural perception, you think that in the distance, and with your dark vision, there is a figure who is moving around a pod, probably about 20 foot away.
I'll wait for the others to come out.
Jump down and immediately hide behind something.
Okay. There's a pod about 10 foot behind you, behind the pipe, that you could maneuver around.
I'm hiding by the pipe. The surface is uneven, right?
Yeah.
So, I mean, presumably there are little indents and pits that we could half hide in anyway.
Yeah, you can do a half hide. Okay, so you're going to duck down.
I'll try and blend in with the natural surroundings as well. I've got that as an elf thing.
Okay, is everyone out of the pipe now?
I'm staying in the pipe. I'm kind of hiding in the pipe.
I'm out of the pipe.
Okay, everyone who's out of the pipe, do a hide check.
Voice.
A witch check, sorry?
Stealth check, stealth. Even. Yes. This is a group check.
Devil, you fat ass.
Yeah, the rogue is the one that can't hide very well.
Oh, man.
Oh, okay, Rob got an 18. Between you, you realise that Pevel and Oryx are not well positioned and you cover them up with your cloaks. And you do a half glance as you see a very thin armoured lizard looking your way. I'm just going to do a quick roll. He has a look. He pauses. You hear nothing for a moment. And then he slowly starts walking towards the pipe and walking towards you.
I'm going to use Disguise Self and Comprehend Languages.
Can I see what's going on quite well from my position in the pipe?
It depends. How much do you want to try?
I want to peek out.
Yeah, you can do a little peek. Do you have dark vision? Yes, you're a dark elf. Yeah. Of course you do. Yeah, you can see the bottom half of a cloaked figure. You can see by the feet that this is definitely a lizard.
Has anyone got a weapon I could have?
You don't have a weapon?
Is this the end of the time to ask this question?
I think I've got a staff you can have if you want it.
Yes, that'll do.
All right, I pass it over.
A character is walking straight towards you. And his natural perception, and he may, well, he gets to here. He's going to do another roll at this point. And he stops, and he does a double take, turns to his right, looks directly at Pevel.
Run, 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 run!
I start to run this way.
I'll leap onto them.
The lizard. Okay. Yeah.
And I'll attack from the other side.
All right, okay. Play it. This is your
different
plans. This is your surprise. Yeah, completely different tactic.
Cool.
All right, do it. These are surprise attacks. Damage 7. Attack of 9 will not do it. Icky, you hit with your second attack, doing 4. Nomo, do you want to tell me what you did?
So I attacked and I hit with a 24, I think.
Yes, you did.
And then 10 piercing. And then I will do a bonus attack.
You can do a bonus victory leap if you want to.
Oh, is he dead?
Yeah, this okay. Thin...
I'll do a bonus swirling roundhouse kick victory leap.
And it falls to the ground.
Stash the body in the pipe.
Yeah.
Okay.
Check him first. Has he got any keys or anything?
Yeah, good idea, actually. Or a map.
Map directions to the secret library.
No, he has basic splint armor and not a lot else.
He has a weapon.
Put him in the pipe. Oh, what weapon has he got?
He has a javelin.
I don't want
to. You should, like, peel off his skin and wear it.
I'll take the javelin as well, actually.
Oh, do you mean because he's a lizard, he must shed his skin?
Well, I was sort of thinking in a more gruesome way, but yeah, sure.
What, was he wearing
a cloak?
I was giving
you a way out.
He was wearing a black cloak, similar to your own.
Okay.
What did he die of? Fright?
He died of severe hemorrhaging, I think, from your blows.
Oh.
So you stashed him away?
Yes, in the pipe, right? In the pipe.
I think that's good. How big are the lizards?
He's probably 5 foot and very thin.
I'll take his javelin as well, then.
You also find on him, it looks like a miniature bell.
Ooh. Someone else say that. When you run, it doesn't bell sound.
It might as well be a sort of a guard's bell that you ring as an alert.
I'll take the bell.
Make sure you muffle it.
Is there a picture of his wife and kids there as well?
I was going to suggest we only knock him out, but, you know.
Right now.
Damage is done.
Murder wins again.
We could just pretend he's knocked out. Or sleeping.
If that helps your conscience, then yeah.
He's just sleeping as blood poured out of the huge wound in his stomach.
Okay, what do you want to do, guys?
I say that we head towards either the contentments or the mountain. Just on a hunch.
The holy mountain?
Yeah.
Are we able to track the path of the guard?
You can certainly try if you want to.
I can't. Good suggestion. That would help.
We were warned about Mount Femmelin. I'm not very good with names.
Sacred Mountain.
Yeah, that's true. Thanks.
We were told that it was unlikely to be there, or we shouldn't really go there because it might be heavily guarded or something.
I thought they said that it was just forbidden to go there, but that made me think that would be the perfect place to hide a secret library. But I don't know.
So we've come out in the contentment, right?
Yes.
I mean, we could give this area try and give it a quick once over. And then move somewhere else, because there's no point in just ignoring this place completely and then finding it is here.
Agreed.
But where to go next, I don't really know.
Okay, let's see what we find in contentment and then decide.
Yeah.
And should we have some sort of plan for the next lizard we come across if we want to be able to ask it questions or something?
We could just knock it out if, you know, we don't have to go straight to murder.
Yeah, sure. Though we can't speak to it, right?
Oryx
can understand them, but that's it.
Yeah, we can't actually speak the language. We can understand it.
We could draw them the script for library in the sand or something, and see what they say.
Yeah,
we could do that.
All right. Time for sneaking.
Yes, the time for sneaking is upon us.
John, I'd like to examine these pods.
No problem. You can examine. And yeah, give me a nature check if you like.
Oh dear. There you are.
Thank you. Probably they come out about 7 foot from the ground. There is a window probably about head height, which it just reveals part of the inside. And the one further away looks a bit more misted over. Essentially, you think somehow the temperature is controlled through the pods. So the pods...
Part of sort of some system of climate control.
Okay. Yeah.
Wow. All right. Should we move on?
creep around somewhere else?
Yeah, sure. That's good.
Yeah. Each pod has a door.
They have doors?
Yes.
Yeah.
Should we look in the pod?
Try and go in one.
I'm going to go in this pod.
This one here? Okay. There's some stairs, just go downward. And you can hear some dripping.
This is weird.
Pretty sure the library wouldn't be wet.
Never know. Moisture farmers.
I will say quietly to Leia, as he's quite close by, that I'm going to go down to see what's there.
All right, Pop's going down. In. No problem. Is everyone else staying there?
I'll come.
I'll stay at the top, keep watch.
I'll stay at the top, too.
Lysa?
I'll stay top.
Yeah.
Okay, 3B go down. You get to the bottom, and what you see ahead of you, it's quite a large room, and in the center, you can see dripping from what looks like a stalactite. It's a great pool, maybe 40 foot across. There appears to be some kind of fishing gear nearby.
What kind of fishing gear?
There's a bucket with something inside. Looks like it was living at some point. A rod. It does have a few stalactites there, and you imagine must go up and beyond the level that you all came in.
Okay, shall we go out and tell the others?
Check
for any other... Are there any other doors or anything down here?
There's another door across. Give me a perception check if you like. Okay, Pebble, what you see is there's a winch to one side, and that the pool is actually shallow. There's a light blueness to it, but it looks almost unreal. In fact, on one side of the pool, away from the fishing equipment, there appears to be some blood. There's an area, a square area, on one side of the pool, where there's blood and there's a small knife and a net and one exit.
This is strange.
One exit back up the stairs? Or
no, across from you.
Oh, okay.
Are there any signs that they gut fish there? So that's what the blood is for?
You think that it may make some sense. You can always inspect the blood if you wish to.
Sure, why not?
All right. It's another nature check.
I'm good at these today.
Yeah, you believe that this is some sort of... It's not human. And it's, as far as you can tell, it's not lizard, but... from your experience upstairs, it's not lizard.
Fine, so there's the other door. Why don't we open the other door? As we're exploring.
Is there anything that Hector, Lys, and Icky that you're doing?
I don't know. How long have the other guys been away for?
About 2 minutes.
Okay,
we ditched them, and they were just holding it back anyway.
I'm just going to kind of keep a low profile, keep watch. Wait for a little longer to see if they come back.
I'll just poke my head in through the other door of the pod.
The one where you are? Okay.
Yeah, assuming there's a door there.
There is.
I've got detect obvious door skill.
That's a brilliant skill. Okay, the one you are looking in, Lys, there are marble shelf borders on the wall of the room which contain many open books.
That'd be too coincidental, wouldn't it?
When you say many, thousands?
Yes.
Thousands?
No. tens and tens.
Tens and tens?
I motion to Hector to come over and have a look.
I go over and have a look.
So you're both in this room with all these books. There are a number of seats which circle and downward into the centre of the room. There's a single stool and what appears to be some sort of platform in front of it with an open book. And the walls are covered in murals.
Are there any entrances or exits?
There appears to be a door. So if you imagine the round room and opposite you, rather than the slope going all the way down, there's a ledge almost dug into the slope, and there's a door there.
If there's any chemical binding books at all.
Okay.
I look for those symbols. The envelope, the EH and the envelope.
Okay. Do an investigation check, Lice.
Oh, 12.
12, okay. No, you do not see that. I mean, you occasionally see a bit of what looks like the H, but yes, it's not combined with the other two symbols. And Hector, all the books appear to be in Draconic or some sort of symbolic language.
We didn't think this through very well, did we?
Okay. The other three. You went past the pool through the next door?
I go back and signal to Ralph to come over.
I'm doing it one room at a time, so...
Okay.
So we'll go back, unless you want to talk to Ralph in the room you're in. We'll play that out.
Well, I'll let Ralph have a look around and...
Okay.
Yeah, I'll have a look around. Not sure what help I'll be, but I'll have a look.
Okay, you see the similar things. Lots of books on marble shelves. Seats going towards the centre, where there is a single stool and a platform with a book on it. There are murals with pictures on it. And there's a single door at the same level as the central platform.
The platform with the book on it?
Yeah.
Is there anything we can read or about that book?
On the book there appears to be a single illustration of a mountain and what appears to be some sort of dark cloud next to it. Otherwise it's all script. That's the page that it's open on.
I flick through a few pages.
Does the mountain look familiar?
Give me a straight intelligence check.
Okay. So you're thinking, because I'm from Mountain, I just want to see if it's in there.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Looks like anywhere I know, but I'll do an intelligence check.
Sure.
There it is.
So you recognise the type of mountain, although the mountain itself isn't familiar to you.
Okay.
You said that you looked through a few more pages?
Yeah.
Okay. You have looked through. There appears to be some kind of flying creature, very large, almost like a giant bird. A bit further along.
I look at Ralph. I look back to the page.
Are you doing a comparison or just...
more of a show, just looking, think about something.
Okay.
I pointed out to Linus. Yeah, I don't spend too long doing it.
Okay.
Well, should we go through this door then?
I can't seem to find any other symbols down here, so yeah, let's have a go.
Okay. So you guys wander through that way. Let's go back to the other party a second. Guys, you go past the dripping pool.
Yeah, that's right. We're going surface. Through a door.
You're going through a door. Ahead of you, you do see a long corridor that goes ahead, with one or two doors on either side of you. And then it seems to split into three different corridors. Again, all these seem to have doors, and you believe you can see some similar grey lizards outside one or two of these doors.
We've opened the door to see this, right?
Yes.
I discreetly close the door again.
Okay. I think so. We need help. We'll go back up the stairs if we can. Yeah. Quietly.
We don't need to go look for trouble, do we?
No.
We have a
reason
to stay, is it?
Okay, so you go back to the surface. To the meringue area.
Yes.
Okay, guys, through the reading area, you go through the door, which is at the same level as the platform. An interesting story about the mountain and the bird. Through this door, you can see a bullywug. The back of this bullywug, and lying on the side is a rather large lizard, eyes closed, as it appears to be being treated, perhaps massaged by this bullywug. The air itself is low lighting. There's some sort of scent in the air.
I don't want to disturb the lizard.
No. I think, back ahead stealthily.
Okay, everyone do a stealth check.
Oh dear.
It's DC 10.
Oh, great.
Oh, less. This is so good.
So, Lice lets out a an inappropriate... What's the sound you make when you see this scene?
Bloody hell!
And the lizard's eyes open. The bullywug turns and stares blankly at you. Go, what do you do?
Attack. Attack the bullywug.
Attack the bullywug. All right. So, yep, it's only about 15 foot ahead of you. You charge straight ahead at the bullywug, who's standing up. Make an attack.
Oh, I missed big time in my javelin.
Did you throw it?
Oh, God.
He threw it end over end.
Bloody hell. Thong. You thrust a javelin and it hits the ceiling and just goes straight back down into your foot. 1d6 damage.
1d6?
Yep.
Nice.
Ralph, are you attacking? Or are you...
can I jump on the lizard to try and stop it from getting up?
That's fine. In theory, the bullywug could attack you, but I don't think it's going to. At this point, it's in shock.
Cool.
So you can do that. I guess that would be a grapple.
What's the AC for the bullywug?
I believe it would have some sort of natural armor, so I'm going to say 11. So a 10 really hit. So basically, you tried to attack it. It didn't work.
So for the grapple, it's athletics contested against its acrobatics or athletics.
Yes.
I think if you're being massaged, there should be a minus.
Yeah, I mean, just disadvantage
prone.
Or something.
It'll have disadvantage because it's prone.
Yeah.
Claws are oily. All
right.
Yeah, that's true, yeah.
Okay. So yeah, let's roll.
Got the mine.
Just roll the mine now. It is, yeah, it's not in a good state at all. It was very relaxed. You grapple it easily. Okay, at this point,
can I see you merging it? See if it
depends how much it's sore. Actually, if I do a perception check for this, it may just have not noticed anything.
And you could fan him with your wings.
You'd actually be great at this, wouldn't you?
A performance check from you and a perception check from him. As you leap on top.
Uh-oh.
Perception check of 6. After a moment, just goes, and settles back down again. In the meantime...
I'm biting my finger, try not to yell. As I pull my javelin out.
In the meantime, it's initiatives. Because there's still a free bullywug. Oh, man.
Oh, excellent.
Bolivar got 2.
Just roll the initiative.
Nice. Then you go first. What do you want to do?
I will attack.
Oh, dear.
I'm not doing very well today.
All right. No. So again, in fact, the Bolivar gets out of the way. So there's just a swish in the air and no contact made. Next up is Icky.
So I'm on the lizard massaging it.
Yes.
What
so
do?
I basically just want to try and like knock it out. I don't have to worry about it anymore.
Okay.
I'm not really sure how to do that.
I think if you do an attack, then it would be an auto crit.
Okay.
So therefore, yeah, I think that's probably. I think that would probably be the best thing.
Okay. Yeah.
If you roll one, I think. Well, that's quite good.
Yeah, I will do that then. I will attack it to try and knock it out, basically.
Okay.
It's not a huge amount of damage, but okay, so I do 9 damage. Which is not a huge amount.
It's not. Do you want to use your second attack?
Yeah, I will actually. Another 7.
Okay.
In fact, I'm gonna use my Flurry of Blows.
Never had a massage like this before. Okay.
Greenish
one.
Okay. Between your three blows, so suddenly this mass starts... It just sighs outwardly and is out cold.
Excellent.
Lice. You have a javelin in your foot.
I'll take it out and throw it at him. The body one.
All right.
11.
That hits.
3.
Although, it's behind Hector, so can you roll again? It's disadvantage.
Oh,
just want to make sure. Yep, absolutely. So, yeah, you do hit. Roll damage.
Okay. 4.
Okay, yep, it takes 4 damage. The bodywork's going to attempt to run away.
Attack of opportunity? I can't remember.
Yeah.
If you still got your reaction, yep.
Actually, yeah, with its bonus action, I'll give it a chance. I'll see if it has the wherewithal to do something about this. It doesn't, though. It just sprints for it. Okay, yeah, attacks.
Would I get a sneak attack bonus on an attack of opportunity?
I think if you're flanking, you might. I'll look it up. I mean, it says once per turn. If you've already done a sneak attack this turn, then...
I have, yeah. So, okay.
Yeah, you can't.
I didn't hit, so I don't know if that counts as doing...
I just don't think... I mean, there's no one in 5 foot of it. It knows you're there, and it's going to attack.
Ralph's in 5 foot of him.
Well, I'm kind of on top of the lizard, so...
Yeah, I think Ralph's engaged, so... No, it'd be a normal attack.
I basically...
Okay, 8 damage then.
All right. Okay, so it's taken 12 damage, and it collapses.
Cool. Well done.
Okay, so you're in this room... which has all those things that you just talked about. There are other tables, but the other tables are unoccupied.
Yeah, John, I'll run up and tell the other guys where we are.
Okay. After a moment, the three of you, who've just returned from the pool pod, you get to the top, and Lice comes out, bleeding a little bit, and he tells you what's going on.
Should we follow them down?
Look, and there's books here. Could this be the library? Someone do an investigation through.
Sure, why not?
No, we've captured this lizard. Should we try and interrogate him using the comprehend language skill and drawing
Absolutely,
symbols?
Yes.
Okay, Pebble, from what you're gathering, you have a look, you do a second take, you judge the murals and the illustrations. You think that this is some sort of storytelling room. This is a gathering room where lizards congregate and tell stories, especially the book about the bird and the lizard in the mountain. This is definitely some sort of the equivalent of the cinema back then.
Awesome.
Oh, you fools, it's a simple storytelling room.
Oh, I didn't know that, did I? I'm telling them off, but...
Well, shall we interrogate the sleeping lizard?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Oryx, get your comprehend languages out.
Yes, sir.
All right.
You want me to read the description, or...?
If I have that spell on, I can just... touch languages and they'll know it, like what they mean.
You can understand books by touching what they're written on. Understand script. Yeah. But you can also understand.
Really? Wow.
Oh, I'll look out somewhere, making sure no one comes on the entrance in.
Okay. Okay, after a time, he wakes up naturally, blinks, puts his hands to its head to feel what's a.
Take your time, come to naturally. Did you enjoy your massage?
Looks up at you, Hector, and then jolts up. Looks quite shocked and sits upright. Starts hissing.
I say there, and start stroking his back. You must drink some water.
You're a psychopath.
Doesn't show any signs of understanding what I'm saying.
It's difficult to comprehend a lizard's expression as to how it feels about this, apart from it being surprised and getting up quickly.
Okay. So, how are you feeling? I smile at it.
Let's see.
Well, how many of these comprehend language spells do you have?
It's a first level spell. He's got 4 first level spells he can use. So he can actually cast it 4 times.
Yeah, but then also I don't think it's a good idea to cast it all 4 times. Because then I can't be able to cast any other spells for a while.
But you want to cast it once now to talk to him?
Once now.
While he's casting it, I'm going to scratch out as best I can the symbol for the library.
Yeah.
Or maybe ask somebody who's better at drawing than I am. So.
Okay.
If you have to scratch it, then I will just draw it.
Okay.
Yes, by all means. Yeah, if you can draw it on the board, that'd be terrific. And that's what he sees.
Oh, right. Okay.
I will say, my good man, could you tell us where the library is, please? Library.
And Oryx, you can hear what he's saying. And I'd like to just write to you in Roll20.
If you go /W and then the name of the person you want to send it to, it should work.
Okay, I'm writing to Oryx then. To everyone else, he's just going...
Yes, yes. The library. The symbols here, I think, mean library in your language, my good man. Could you please tell us where it is?
How's that?
So he listens to
I nod my head.
He looks... he looks in puzzlement at the sketch that you've drawn.
How dare he? It's a fine representation of the library drawing.
No, we are real. I'll nod my head no.
No, I think you're talking Klingon, mate.
No, we are not slaves.
He looks around nervously.
Carefully.
Do you think he knows what we're looking for?
I'm going to thump the symbols that they've drawn with my fist.
I point to them.
And then look at him.
What's he saying? What's he saying?
He's saying that we're going to be killed.
I'll brandish my spear at him, point it towards them to show that we mean business.
It's getting more and more menacing. He sounds like a Dothraki or something now.
But
what's he saying?
Has he given any indication that he knows what we're looking for?
Well, he made a very good point. If we're not going to let him go anyways, then why would he tell us?
Has he said anything about the library? Does he know that's what we're looking for?
Yes, he says we're not going to let him go. Maybe we just knock him out, tie him up, and leave.
Can we convince him that we will let him go?
Yeah, okay, we can lie.
I wasn't lying, but yeah, and okay.
We could plausibly promise to just knock him out and tie him up if he's helpful and to kill him painfully. If he's not.
So is he sat up at the moment?
Yes.
I go back and start massaging him and then point at the thing saying, where is it, my friend? We don't mean to hurt you.
Do a performance check, Ben.
Pretty good.
Yeah, this is
yours. What is he saying?
He's asking, who is this angel from hell?
I go in front of him and say, my name is Hector. Now, if you let us know where this is, and I point very pointedly at the symbols, say, we will let you go and you can have a nice life being a lizard somewhere. And I smile.
I'm going to gesture all of us except the lizard, and then I'm going to gesture just to the lizard and then point like at the ground.
Staying
in the room. So we'll leave and then he can just stay here, tied up.
I'm going to ask him, hey, do you understand common?
A little.
Can you please tell us where the library is?
Library. What?
I'll point at the symbols again.
Yes.
Me? No. No. You need. And he makes the shape of someone smaller than him. He goes, and then points to your armor, Lice. Huh? Like, huh?
Rob, you got your armor recently at the market, didn't you? Lice.
Yes.
We have to go to the Grey Lizard offices. They have maps for everything.
Okay.
And where are these Grey Lizard offices?
One of the three places. Not Congress, not where we are now, the other one.
And he points in a direction.
Okay, and I put my face very close to his and says, why didn't you tell us you understood common in the first place before letting us fuck about for 5 minutes?
He says, leave me alone, you tendered finger demon. Tendered
demon. Maybe he can show us directly to the offices. We can keep him alive if he's useful to us.
You'll be a liability.
Who's next to him? Ben is, isn't he? Oh. He grabs the weapon out of your sheath and starts to pummel himself on the head.
You mean he's trying to hurt himself?
Isn't he tied up?
No, we didn't tie him up. John, do you mean he's trying to hurt himself? Oh dear, he is.
Yeah, appears to be. And he collapses again on the floor.
I put a knife in his forehead.
That'll do it.
So right, off we go then.
Wow, that was uncalled for.
I wink at Ralph.
We should double time it to the grey elves, grey lizards rather.
Okay. So you head towards configuration, did you say?
Yes.
All right, based on the map and also the direction that the lizard pointed, you know approximately where you're going. You come to a new area. And as opposed to the other colours, which were, it was far more reddish colours of the pods now become grey colours and reflect shining off the natural red light which is coming out. You are in, you presume, configuration. I'd like perceptions.
9.
19.
Wow, we're all doing very well.
Okay. No, mate, you're still reliving the previous conversation when all of a sudden you see Hector and Pevel looking around and they see ahead of them, probably two pods away, two guards, similar to the one which you saw before.
Let's hide behind some pods.
Yeah, let's.
Yes.
Okay, so they're slightly further ahead, the pods, so you can creep towards there.
Yeah.
Oh, you're already stealthing, that's good. Yep, stealth away. Wonderful. What?
We should really have the sneakers moving a tiny bit ahead of the black-vested types in our ivory, because we shouldn't be around here.
I'm actually supposed to be pretty good at sneaking.
Well,
usually pretty good too.
Okay, between you,
oh, wow.
You see Nomo stumble, but you manage to, between you, keep the noise level down, and he gets to the pod. You don't think they've heard you. And so you're by the first pod. You can see the door just there. Otherwise, there's some pods further along.
Shall we try going in a pod? I mean, I don't know how to distinguish between them from the outside anyway.
Yeah, I think we'll have to go in sooner or later.
Yeah, I think so.
Let's open the door quickly and quietly and see what's inside.
In the first one you go into, it appears to be empty. There are gaming tables around the side of the room. It's a high ceiling, and in the centre, you can see a pit. In the pit, there are bloodstains and a few what looks like splints from bones.
Doesn't sound like a place where maps are kept to me.
There also appears to be some kind of lift mechanism at the top of there, and there's a door to the left. So if you went halfway around the pit, there's a door there.
I'll take a peek through the door. Cautious, right. Please.
Through the door, stairs lead down.
Should we go and have a quick look?
Maybe we should just send a stealthy party to investigate.
We'll at least send them first. Yeah, okay.
Okay. Stealthy party, please put your hands up or say your name.
I'm all stealthy.
Am I stealthy?
You tell me.
I think I'm stealthy.
If you think you're stealthy, I'm not stealthy. Maybe the other way around, but I'm not sure.
I think I'm stealthy, but I tend to always roll really badly, so I don't actually know if I am.
This should only take a second anyway.
Okay.
Cool.
Is it Pevel and Hector?
I'll go well. I'm stealthy.
How many people are we able to fit in there?
It's just get a staircase, so anyone can come.
Oh, okay. I'm pretty stealthy. I've got +7. So.
Why don't we just basically all go, but have Oryx and Lysa go last?
That's a good idea.
How can just one person go and report back?
Send your weasel.
A weasel.
Yeah, a weasel will work.
Yeah, do that.
He'll die. He'll always die.
Yeah, but at least he comes back.
Yeah, but he's not lost forever like we would be.
Okay.
I'll throw him in.
I give you 5-1. He'll come back.
What? Wait. I bet on the odds of 5-1 that he'll come back.
Yes.
I'll take that bet.
So 10-1 that the lizards eat him.
I follow him up the stairs. I don't. No.
So you've thrown the weasel in. That's the only creature going down these stairs, yeah?
Yeah.
All right.
Yep.
Weasel, do a stealth check.
Just roll d20, maybe?
Do 2 d20s. Take the best.
Oh.
2 and a 20?
That's the most cunning weasel.
A most impressive weasel, sir.
Yeah. You threw him in, and the next thing you know, he didn't even hit the floor. He was gone. And through his eyes, what you're seeing, Oryx...
is a lady weasel.
You never saw him again. The end. Stairs lead down. And there appears to be various tables below. Through your weasel vision, if he so wants, he can pretty easily scramble up one of these table legs. Have a look.
Okay,
it scrambles up. Oh, goodness. Sharp implements. Some sort of weird-looking seat, which doesn't look comfortable at all. Ropes. No exits.
This might be a torture chamber.
All right.
I think so.
But in one wall, there is darkness lies behind iron grates.
Ooh.
I'll do a perception check first with my weasel.
All right, perception check. And if you want to tell me anything in particular that you're looking for, let me know.
You're looking for anything in particular?
Not really.
Okay.
Just look for everything.
General perception. Okay.
Ooh.
Okay. You can tell that it goes a little further in. There's some whimpering coming from somewhere behind the darkness. And there's also some deep breathing. It sounds much lower in tone. The ground itself rumbles a little when the breathing goes out.
I'll tell the group about there's something down there. I think if we do go down there, we have to be really, really cautious and ready for battle.
Well, what is it? Can't you get your weasel any closer? Figure out what it is?
Send them all in.
No.
I'm not going down until I know exactly what's there. So, you know.
It has deep breathing.
Okay, so there's something down there, but...
if I get my weasel any closer, first it'll alert it. And then also, it's going to have, like, weasel stew.
There's no map.
Yeah, exactly. Should we just try a different pod? I don't see that any need to go and confront big creatures.
What if it's something that might be able to help us?
Well, I'll get my wizard to get a closer look.
Okay, which area do you go to? There were two noises. One was whimpering, one was deep breathing.
I'll go to the whimpering first.
Okay, do you want to do it stealthily or not?
Yes, please.
Okay, two rolls. D20s.
The weasel puts his foot in a bucket.
Really small bucket. Again, you stealthily go towards the darkness. It's difficult to make out, but your weasel eyes acclimatise a little bit, and you can see a bit further in. Past these grates, you can see what appear to be two creatures. They're moving very, very rapidly in a very small motion, so you make that out to be some sort of shivering. And they're in a corner, away from the other cell. Not sleeping, but barely moving. Just that shivering, whimpering. They haven't noticed you, but they're humans.
Ooh. So one's grunting and one's whimpering? Or are they both whimpering?
Both whimpering.
I'll go over to the grunting then.
Okay, again, give me the 2d20s.
Oh, man.
You can get right up close to the bars. You're that confident about this. You look inside, and there is some sort of... Imagine giant sausages for fingers. You can see that within the shadow, this very long, muscly arms. Reddish colour, if anything. Breathing uneven. You notice large footprints. Very large footprints. Although all footprints are quite large to weasels. But you think this is large. You can make out half of a face, which is disfigured by lizard or human proportions. Very flat nose. Hair protruding in random directions.
That's sort of creepy. Okay, I'll tell the group about this. We should probably go down and investigate it.
Well, if there's humans there, they may be helpful to us.
They might just slow us down.
Well, we don't have to bring them with us. But they might have information. We don't really know where this library is.
Well, I suppose so.
How many humans?
Two.
Mm-hmm.
And a big red, muscly,
hairy, sausage-fingered.
Yeah.
Well, we just go and talk to them.
Okay, sounds good.
Okay.
We'll have a civilized talk.
Should we go down?
I march down there.
Recall your weasel.
Oh yeah, I'll recall my weasel.
No, keep him there, Mike.
Really? Okay, I won't then.
How do you approach? Are you still
walk down normally.
Normally? Okay.
Do what you did with your bow and arrow. Do the 1, 2, 3, the fire thing.
No, I'm just going to talk to them.
Well, you got to shoot the big hairy thing first.
Yeah, I'll have my bow ready.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, is the big hairy thing attacking them?
It will do.
You think that there's some sort of wall between them? All right. So as you go down, you see everything that was explained to you by Oryx is there. You can also see next to the cells that there are some levers on either side of these two cells.
Should we just go talk to the big hairy guy?
Sure, let's.
Okay, as you get close, they haven't changed position yet, they're still. But you can see, as was described, there they are in the corner, shivering. With your dark vision, you can make them out. They're looking in pretty poor condition. The other creature looks quite warped. You're not quite sure what creature it is. It certainly has power, though.
Yeah, let's just hit it hard then. Shoot it and all kinds of stuff like that.
Is it incarcerated?
You can see a chain attached to it, and it's in a cell.
Well, it's not going anywhere, is it? Just leave it alone.
Oh. All right.
I thought it was wandering around. Sorry.
I just go in into the door then and say, oh, hello.
I'll be watching for guards.
Okay. The other side, you can see one of the humans is pushing the other one, who's female, and jolts awake and looks up and goes, Cat! What?
Hello?
They're taking us away. Is it time?
Time for what?
Time for the ritual.
Which ritual was this again?
We're not here for any rituals. We're here to save you.
Yes. Can it be? I've never had such a nightmare.
It can be.
Who are you?
Do you know anything about a library?
They look blankly at you. Library, books, library. Why? Why do you want a library?
Yeah.
Why wouldn't we want to go to a library?
We're here in search of a great library. If you can help us, maybe we could set you free.
What cruel torment is this? Who cares about old books? Please help us. Please help us. Please. We have to be sacrificed. Please do not let us die.
You don't know where you're going to be sacrificed, do you?
The mountain. They sacrificed us to their god.
The god of books?
I don't understand. They sacrificed us to Sumuanya, the lizard god.
That's the sacred place.
There's probably a library in the sacred place.
Don't go there. Take us away from there. Don't go to Sumuanya. Take us with you.
Pegasus.
We really like books. We must get to this library.
Well, what do you want to know about books? Oh.
Well, we could take them with us.
That's probably not it. Yeah. I'll try talking to the big hairy thing.
Yeah? It's having a bit more trouble. It hasn't responded yet. Oh. Do you talk to it?
Yes.
Is that you, Rob?
Gets up and two beady eyes look as if it's looking straight through you, Rob.
Oh. You're about as beaten up as I am.
And it goes, it jumps at the cage and rattles the bars.
Now then.
Take us away from here.
Where were you captured, anyway?
I'm going to be watching the entrances to this room with my arrow knocked.
I'm going to try and say something soothing to calm down the big guy, Sean.
Okay.
There's a performance check for you.
Sure.
Give me a massage.
Nice. Mm. That's to the big creature, is it?
Yeah.
Okay. It seems to be calmer. He says, listen, we were brought here as slaves in a market. We were bought by the lizards as sacrifice. The last 2 months have been hell ever since we were taken from our village. Please, take us from here. We either must fight this creature or we are sacrificed. What an awful way to die. He must take us away.
Which creature? This creature.
Yes.
Oh.
If we kill it, then you'll be free.
I like your logic, Lice.
No. Don't hit it. It'll only provoke it.
Let's just take them with us.
Well.
Oh, bollocks, that flows down. Come on, let's go. Nothing here.
They don't seem to be very keen on books. That's what we look for in our companions.
It's cruel. It's very cruel not to take them.
Yeah, I'm with Pevel. I think we should at least let them go.
Pevel, make a wisdom saving throw. Okay, yep. That's fine. You still think that. Yeah, it's up to you.
Well, what would you do?
Let's just go. Come on. I'll go upstairs.
Don't leave
us. If you came with us, you would have to help us. Otherwise, you'd wander around, be found, and raise the alarm.
Of course. We'll carry things for you. We'll fight for you, whatever it takes.
There you go.
You wouldn't run away?
No. We don't know where to go. We have nowhere to go.
Do you speak Draconic?
Good question.
And this is probably one of the last things we'll do because I know we have to stop. I'm going to leave that one to chance. Roll the d6, Ben. If you get a 6, they do.
Go on, Ben. Oh, Ben.
No,
oh, Ben.
We don't.
So, anyone else want to ask them?
It doesn't work again.
Wow. Can you speak Draconic?
Computer says no.
Well, we're taking them with us, scientists. Where are the keys?
There are three levers on the wall.
I put the levers. No, wait.
I see a dilemma here. We don't want to release the big, sweaty one.
Okay, I'll deal with it. Everyone else out.
Oh, yes.
I suppose we could just kill the big, sweaty one. Like, isn't he behind bars? Arrows go through
bars.
Why
should we kill him, save the other two?
Well, I address the two people and the one that we've been speaking to.
Uh-huh. I'm not sure. It's not the far one. It's one of the other two.
Okay, so...
Wait, so there are three levers.
Yes.
One of them is the beast cell.
Yes.
What's the third one?
It opens a door behind us to the pit.
No.
And the far one, is that for the beast or the pit?
The pit, I think.
Oh, come on.
Okay, everyone else get out of the room and back up the stairs.
I get out of the room.
I'm already out.
Okay.
I'm out.
All right.
Now, think. Which one of these two levers opens your cage?
I've got memories of Uhtred stuck in a toilet with a female troll.
That's not... I'm not sure.
Okay, I try the one that's next to the far one.
The one in the middle?
I guess so.
Okay. You pull the lever,
yeah.
And we'll find out what happens next week.
Excellent. Thanks.
Bye, guys.